Opposition figures in Bangladesh sought to stoke anti-India sentiments, particularly as Sheikh Hasina secured her fourth consecutive term in office, bolstering her close ties with India. After months of silence, Prime Minister Hasina has launched a full-scale offensive against the opposition's Boycott India campaign. Known for a fondness for traditional attire like the sari, Hasina utilized this cultural symbol to confront her political adversaries. Opponents of Hasina and her Awami League party have tried to brand her pro-India and claimed India helped her win the January elections. They started a campaign appealing to the people of Bangladesh to boycott Indian products. After remaining silent for months as the issue simmered, Hasina hit out at leaders of the Bangladesh Nationalist Party, BNP, Bangladesh's principal opposition party, and flipped the script of the Boycott India campaign. After securing a sweeping victory in the January elections from which the BNP boycotted, Hasina employed the symbolism of the humble sari to educate BNP leaders who had been advocating for a Boycott Indian Products campaign on social media. Hasina, who has consistently praised India as a great friend, posed a pointed question last week. How many Indian saris do their wives own? This remark, delivered with a touch of humor, drew a few chuckles at the Awami League office in Dhaka. Hasina, who herself is known for her love for saris and gifting them to Indian leaders, then put forward a sari test for the opposition leaders. When they burn their wives' Indian saris in front of their party office, only then will it be proven that they are truly committed to boycotting Indian products, she said as she launched the sari attack. Not just sari test, the Bangladesh Prime Minister also alleged that the BNP leaders and their wives used to buy saris from India and sell them in Bangladesh. When the BNP was in power, I had seen wives of their leaders flying to India in groups to buy Indian saris. They would sell the saris in Bangladesh, alleged Hasina. It was not just the Indian sari that Sheikh Hasina referred to. She sprinkled a handful of Indian spices in the pot too. I have one more question. We are importing garam masala, onion, garlic, ginger and many other items from India. Why don't the BNP leaders cook without Indian spices? They must cook and eat food made without these spices, said Sheikh Hasina. The uproar surrounding the Boycott India campaign escalated online, reminiscent of similar movements like the India Out trend in the Maldives. In the aftermath of Hasina's triumph, there were instances of resistance to Indian goods and commodities reported in February. Markets in Dhaka, typically abundant with Indian products, declined to accept fresh deliveries. Sales of Indian items such as cooking oil, processed foods, toiletries, cosmetics and clothing experienced a notable decline.